coming out of the commissioner's operational plan. This morning, about 5 a.m. this morning, we... coming out of the operational plan by the commissioner. This morning, we on the take an operation about 5 a.m. this morning, where we execute a warrant at the Hermitage Village in San Fernando, and where we seize large quantity of arms and ammunition and cocaine. The officers were involved were Mr. Gajida, Inspector, and ASP Mohammed, and the other officers of the Southern Division operational team. There were ongoing intelligence, and as a result of this intelligence, it manifest this, the results are there to see what the intelligence brought. So we have an AK-47, with two magazines, a large quantity of ammunition, two pistols, and a revolver, with all ammunition that literally have. Also, there's cocaine there, a large amount of cocaine, with an estimated street value about $1.6 million, and a small quantity of marijuana, with an estimated value about So, this is our result. We want to ensure people of San Fernando and by extension to the middle that the police service is performing, is doing the job that we have set out to do. The commissioner's directives are being undertaken and the operational plan are in force. So, we want to commend the officers of the Southern Division, headed by Mr. Ali Morbin and Inspector Gajida, for the remarkable job that they did. And we have a longer road ahead to retrieve firearms off the street, to reduce violent crimes, and all other crimes that affect the lives of the people of Southern Division. So again, this is the result of our success.
Well,
you know, trying to make a lot of access to these waters. So we have porous borders that we need to address. It comes in from the sea. We have the Cedars, we have the Southwestern Peninsula that makes its way into the mainland, and we have the North Coast, we have the Moruga District. So it comes in by persons who want to commit crime and to treat with their drug trade. So where there's drugs, there's guns.
Of course, but so, weapons like these, I mean, no specifics. But if someone, a small fish, for instance, have access to be able to bring this in, that's like...
Well, remember the drug trade. The drug trade is a serious trade. It's heavily, it's aligned to trafficking, whether it's human trafficking, whether it's drugs, whether it's guns. So when there's drugs, there must be guns. So when they're applying their illegal trade, this, you must protect the trade. And you protect the trade with heavy firepower. And this are the weapons that we have. Also, I must add that we arrested two other persons for shotgun and 4 rounds of ammunition in St. Mary's District. And this is coming out of the vigilance and the intelligence of the persons in St. Mary's, officers of St. Mary's Post.
But you all think you're good in the battle. I mean, I know there's an increase of firearms being taken off the street. But as much as you all take off guns off the streets, there's more coming in.
Well, we only could do that much. As it comes into the country, we have our intelligence officers in force, working, trying to get information, and we have the operational team who are doing and performing way beyond the call of duty.
But you think you're winning the battle?
Well, we have to. We cannot stop. It's an ongoing fight unless we take care of our borders and curtail those areas that brings in the legal arms and drugs. So we only could do this much. As long as it comes in the mainland, we will deal with it.
Are you saying that you all need the same amount of fight from the other local law enforcement authorities as you all are putting out?
See,
the same amount of effort that you all are putting out, you all need it from the other law enforcement?
Yes, we have to complement our function along with the Coast Guard, the customs. We need the support. So when that support matches our effort, we will really fight against crime and illegal fire.
So the bond bill was passed yesterday, and of course I'm sure you all are aware of the bill where there's going to be no bail for 120 days. We've had, you know, many reports where people on bail have been committing crime to seek the money for bail and to pay attorneys. Do you think this may put a dent in people, you know, people with possession of weapons and ammunition?
Well, it will curtail the person from getting bail easier and faster. It will restrict them and make it difficult. And, you know, and it will help the police in the discharge of their function.
So you applaud?
Of course. Anything to assist the police officers of the Trinidad with the police service, it will be commendable.
Do you think the OPVs would have made any difference to this form of business?
I don't want to answer that question. I mean, they want to cater to political standing, but I mean, anything that help the police in discharge of their function, it will be welcome.
Can you tell us a little bit more about this and how dangerous it is?
Mr. Gajida.
Just
identify yourself, please, sir.
Inspector Gajida, CID Southern Division, in charge of the operation of the CID. This fire here is an AK-47. It is one of the most sophisticated sets of assault rifle that we have. We see it in the Middle East. So seeing this firearm in Trinidad, it is really amazing that we have this sort of thing in Trinidad now. There are two magazines that goes with the firearm, as well as some ammunition. But what is really interesting about all of these, we have a revolver, we have a 9mm Taurus pistol. What is really amazing, this firearm, it's a 5.7. I have never seen a firearm like this in Trinidad. It uses very small rounds, similar to the 7.62, but very small. And if you look it up on Google, you would see that it is used by the Secret Service in America as well as the FBI. So it is very interesting that we have a firearm like this. We have never seen it in Southern Division. I have never seen it. It is surprising that we have firearms like this. It is also a fully automatic pistol, which makes it even worse, because I'm not sure of the capacity of the magazine, but I'm sure we have 20-something odd rounds inside of there. So that is extremely interesting. Four firearms off the street. We feel proud about it, but not proud in the sense that we feel proud to take it off the streets. But when we look at what we have to deal with on the streets, it is really, you know, dangerous to us. Whilst we would have taken our wood to protect and serve, we want to make sure that the public is safe, but we want to let the public know that what we are up against when we leave our homes to come and serve you. So again, thanks again for coming. As a resident, we have a person detained in relation to that.
Can you tell us how old?
He's about 29 years.
29.
No, he's not employed as far as we
mean. Otherwise employed.
He was in 2010. He was arrested in Princeton during the state of emergency as a gang member. Subsequently, the matters were dismissed against him. He was part of that operation in Princeton in 2010. So he's known to the police, and this is the results we have today.
We need the ammunition ones.
All right, so
this is the cocaine.
That's what cocaine looks like.
This is what cocaine looks like.
So we officially clear.
Listen, there's no look. There's no.
If
you sorry, so over this time, you can feel free.
Can you tell us?
There was a shooting. There was an incident in the Monibo district last night. As a matter of fact, where there was a robbery at a house. The police responded promptly and on arrival they were greeted with gunfire. The police had to take cover. Last night, however, the suspect was not here. Coming out of the same exercise, the officers continued that search for that suspect and he was held about 1 hour.
Was shots fired at the police officer at any time yesterday?
That is the same incident I'm speaking of.
Mm-hmm. How many shots were fired and did you all return fire?
I can't say how much shots was fired. It's subject to investigation as we speak. But what I'm going to tell you is that the suspect was in fact held today.
You all had an exercise today?
Yes, an exercise that resulted in all these.
No, in Mon Repo.
Throughout the division had exercise.
Okay.
And it's continuous throughout the Easter. Mm-hmm. The Easter holidays.
Anybody, you all have anybody who was shot and in under police guard at hospital?
Coming out of an incident today, arising from the same exercise. Mm-hmm. Three persons were seen acting suspicious, and again in the Monibo district.
Tordale in particular.
The police approached them and they fired at the police. The police returned fire. One of the suspects was shot. He was in the hospital. He's undergoing treatment as we speak.
Can you tell us where he's from, if you know?
I do have that address at present, but it's like that.
Pleasant.
21-year-old
suspect.
Thank you.
Okay, so thank you for coming, and feel free to have your photographs.
Gajada, Inspector Gajada.
Is this cooking?
Yes, it is. It says cooked. Why did you get it?
Declared.
Let me go for
it.
Call it back. She's my wife. Tell her where I am. Call it back.
Why that?
New
Okay.
Ask her
where she
is. Is it?
No.
Just
no.
Okay.
Oh, let's come back on.
You want a piece of me, girl? Again.
The officer's hands are getting tired.
The same suspect in relation to the secret.
We can look at the ammunition inside.
Yeah, that's it.
I don't know.
You look up on your hand, take it off.
in a 5.7, and you get these firearms. The type of rounds that you use.
Okay, you see that bag there? Nothing happened with that. If you look at that, first, yeah, well, we have to see.
You can like cake, boy. Sugar cake.
However, today, officers would have gone back to the police station when they would have seen that same individual in company with two other persons. When they approached them, the same three, the same one who had fired at the police last night, he again fired at the police, who returned fire, but they struck another one of the persons who was in company with him.
So this is in regards to the, in reference to the Monrico?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thanks.
You know
he is 21. 21 years, he's from Pleasantville. He's Taras. I think he has short hair.
Is the one who was arrested for the robbery?
He was shot today. The one who was watching for the shooting, he escaped.
Right, but he was arrested today.
No. He's still at large. The guy who shot at the police last night, he was seen today, but right. He escaped.
Oh, so he escaped today?
He escaped today, but his accomplice was in his company with him, who fired at the officer. He was shot.
Okay.
So the guy who shot at the police last night, he escaped. However, his friend was shot.
Who's present? How many years did he escape?
He also escaped. Two escaped, one was shot, and he's presently in New York.
So the 21 year old is one of the
right.
And from Poké?
Yes, presently.
The man was shot at the police.
He escaped. He's still at last. But
how old is he?
He's 23.
He's from Poké?
He's from the Taradale area.
Okay, so last night was Monrico, today it's Pleasant.
Yeah, but it's the same, but basically it's the same area, and I think a Poké, Monrico is almost the same in the vicinity of the old ice factory.
Okay.
And that is where Forest Avenue is where he shooting would have occurred last night. So it's just a walking distance from
Blitz Village.
Yeah. Okay. Not Blitz Village, behind the ice factory, it'll be more St. Joseph. It's going by the traffic light. Remember, if you go there, you will come back on Forest Avenue. So it's one link. It's a link. It's just the same road.
There's a track to go through Blitz Village to come to Poké.
A quantity of drugs was found on the scene also,
okay.
But I cannot say
in the bushy
area, and it's a track that they use as a shortcut from Forest Avenue to go into the UTT, there's a track area.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you know how much drugs?
No, the sergeant wasn't able to get the quantum as yet because he had to be with anything like that. Stable. He got injuries to the lower abdomen. But not life threatening. I think he was stable up to 2:30 when he would have dealt with by the doctor. He was considered stable.
But the guy who was shot at the police today is the same one who shot at the police.
Yes. He had used the helicopter together with the dogs, but however, he was not.
Today?
Yes. Pardon me?
What is your position?
ESP operations. Yes. Ali.
Ali Muhammad, right. Thank you.
Is he alive?
MOHA
Ali. ESP.
Operations. ESP Ali Muhammad.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm based in San Fernando.
How much?